Manila's 83-man response team arrives in Istanbul to help in search and rescue efforts. They landed in Turkey past noon, Manila time. According to Dr. Tedes Guerra, a rescue doctor of the Philippine Urban Search and Rescue Team, they've been assigned to help search efforts in Adana province in southern Turkey.
The team is all in high morale. Yung ating Turkish counterparts, no, offer ng makain sa amin, and we were all here in one place, kasama yung Hong Kong, USAR team, South Africa, mayroong China USAR team, other USAR team from other parts of the world. So dito namin pinag-decisionan ang tinatawag na IMT namin para dito. The embassy ng Pilipinas dito sa Turkey, yung ibang staff nandoon sa Adana para tulungan, ma-facilitate ang movement ng Philippine team.
Other news now, Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. secures investment pledges from Japanese companies. This is after he presided over a meeting attended by stakeholders in Tokyo's semiconductor and electronics industries. Malacanang says the total amount of investment commitment will be announced tomorrow, February 10th, during the signing of letters of intent by the firms. Though it notes the pledges are expected to generate over 10,000 jobs for Filipinos. Marcos says he wants Manila to become a regional hub for printers, wiring harnesses, and other electronic goods. The Philippine Coast Guard says crew members of a distressed vessel now docked in Tacloban have yet to produce the necessary documents to be allowed to disembark. Commodore J. Tariela says they are coordinating with the Bureau of Immigration to determine what to do with the foreign crew. The vessel was rescued off the coast of Eastern Samar in late January.
The one claiming to be the ship owner's representative hasn't really presented any documents that this vessel is really registered from China, and even the ownership of the vessel is not yet established. For the Philippine Coast Guard, it's suspicious that these documents, statutory documents to prove the registry and the ownership of the vessel, is not present on board the vessel.
Commodore Tariela also says they're ready to take part in joint patrols in the West Philippine Sea. He, however, admits there's a need to further improve the assets of the Coast Guard to conduct regular maritime patrols.
With the compliance of the Philippine Coast Guard with the guidance of our President Bongbong Marcos to intensify the Coast Guard presence in the West Philippine Sea, our Coast Guard vessels will be constantly patrolling the West Philippine Sea. This in the interest of protecting the welfare of our fishermen who are also reportedly being bullied by China Coast Guard. So we believe that it is important for the Philippine Coast Guard to maintain its presence there.
We're monitoring a fire that broke out this afternoon at the Araneta Bus Center in Cubao, Quezon City. Our correspondent Jose Carretero now on the line with the details. Jose, go ahead.
Yes, Ron, good afternoon. A fire broke around 4:30 this afternoon at the old Araneta bus station here in Cubao. As of now, firefighters from different fire departments have been deployed to help contain the fire, which is now on third alarm. Ron, I've talked to the terminal manager, Ramon Legaspe. He said the fire started around 4:30 this afternoon. The fire raised food establishments and convenience store inside the building. At the other area, Ron, are the city bus station flying the route around here in Metro Manila. According to Terminal Manager Legaspe, passengers were evacuated so far, and establishment tenants were evacuated also. So far, Ron, there's no recorded casualty as of this time. Ron?
Jose Carretero giving us an update on that fire at the old Araneta bus station. Jose, thank you very much.